Hi and welcome. Depending upon the security requirements of an organization, an information system may operate in any of the security modes while it is being deployed in a mandatory access control environment. In this video, I will discuss these security modes of operations of information systems. Now, there are certain requirements before an information system may get deployed in any of the security mode. Now, these requirements are more pertinent to the military or government contractors. For example, US Department of Defense has published a manual known as DITSCAP Manual or Department of Defense Information Technology Security Certification and Accreditation Process Manual. Now, these requirements states that there should be a mandatory access control environment before an information system is deployed in any of the security modes. Moreover, the physical access to the room or to the computer console should be restricted by implementing physical access control. Now, there are four security modes of operations in which an information system gets deployed. And these security modes are dedicated, system high, compartmented, and multi-level security modes. Now, an information system may get deployed in any of these security modes depending upon the security requirements of a organization. Now, there are certain attributes which are associated with these security modes of operations, and I will discuss these attributes one by one. Now, first attribute is the PDMCL, which stands for whether the system can process data at multiple classification levels. So, if an information system is deployed in dedicated or system high security mode, then this system can process only the data at single classification level. But once the system is deployed in compartmented or multi-level security mode, then this system can process data or at multiple classification levels. Now, this CMW stands for Compartmented Mode Workstations. So, the requirements for compartmented workstations are two, which are related with the security labels of the data or the object which is being processed by the system. So, CMW requirement states that the data should have two labels. One is the sensitivity label, which indicates the level of protection required by the data. And second one is the information label, which is an additional piece of information to avoid over classification of the data or the object. Now, this signed NDA attribute states that the users of this information system, once it is deployed in any of these security modes, should have signed NDA to access all the information by these systems. So this attribute is same for all the security modes. Now, next attribute is the security clearances. So it states that the user should have security clearance to access all the data processed by the information system once this information system operates in dedicated or system high security modes. But once the system is operating in compartmented or multi-level security mode, then the system or the user of this system do not require clearances for all the data processed by the system. Rather, in compartmented security mode, the user of that information system should have highest classification label of the data processed by this information system. And in the multi-level classification or multi-level security mode, the user should the user clearance level to dominate the classification label of the object. Now, next attribute is the access approval. So once this system is deployed in dedicated or system high security mode, then the user should have access approval for all the data processed by these two systems. Since the dedicated and system high security mode basically process the data at single classification, so the users should have access approval to access all the data which operates at single classification level. But once the system is operating in compartmented or multi-level security modes, then the user of that information system requires access approval for only the specific data, and rest of the data is not is restricted to that user. Now, next attribute is the need to know. It means that the user of information system should have a business need to know a particular piece of data processed by the information system, and this need to know will ensure that the user is able to perform its work or its job. So once the system is deployed in dedicated security mode, then the user should have need to know of all the data processed by the dedicated mode system. But once the system is deployed in system high or compartmented or multi-level security modes, then this user should have access to the required should have need to know to the required piece of data on the these system, and rest of the data is not accessible to the user. Now, next attribute is the administration. So administration is more complex or difficult, or you can say there is less automation and more admin or human involvement in dedicated security mode. But once the system is deployed in system high or compartmented or multi-level security mode, then this human involvement is less and there is more automation. And in multi-level security mode, there is the more automation and less human administration. So here you can see that the multi-level is the least secure and most risky security modes in which an information system may get deployed, depending upon the security requirement of that organization. And this dedicated security mode is most secure. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected to my channel for similar videos and do subscribe my channel. Thank you.